Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. My topic today is the secret of chakra core, 10 ways to go beyond the edge. And firstly, please let me introduce myself and my partner. My partner is Li Nanhao, and because short of credentials for visa, he can't come here. So today's presentation will be made by myself. My name is Long Liu, and we both from 360 Work and Team, China. Here is our team and targets we pound in pound to earn and pound fist. And we got Master of Pound to Earn in 2017. My topic consists of four parts. Firstly, we will briefly introduce the background of chakra. Then, we will introduce how to find the bugs from the developer's point of view. We will introduce some exploit skills in Chakra. Finally, we will introduce how to bypass CFG and IFG. Now let's start from the first part, Chakra summary. Chakra is the latest version of Microsoft's script engine, which was born in a security era. So security is one of its main features. Secondly, a large number of optimization technologies are used in Chakra. And it is also the script engine that supports most of new features. Now, Chakra is open sourced as project called Chakra Core. So why do we choose to find the Chakra's vulnerabilities? Firstly, the script engine is the most powerful module compared with DOM. Vulnerabilities in script engine can achieve RCE more easily. And open source is also a very important factor so that we can easily dig deeper into the core. From a historical point of view, any newly developed engine is not as good as expected at first. The result is that we found many bugs in the first round of the code review. Now let's talk about how to find bugs in Chakra in the perspective of the developers. After reading the source code of Chakra, you will notice that the logic and structure is very clear, which uses a lot of C++ features. So we can think from the point of view of C++ characteristics to find out what mistakes developers may make in the meantime finding some security issues. Firstly, let's talk about the template. The template is divided into class template and function template. It is used to reduce the amount of code. As for programmers, they only need to consider the logic of the function and needn't to consider the types. However, it may lead to type confusion. Next, we will use function template to illustrate the problem caused by template in Chakra, and vulnerabilities related will also be showed. Function template is an abstraction of many similar looking functions, which function is actually called depending on the type of arguments. Of course, we can also force it to choose which function to use. Both the two ways of selection may lead to security problems. We will illustrate them one by one. As shown in the figure, if the type of parameters passed to swap is int, then int corresponding function is called. If the type of parameters is float, float corresponding functions will be called. programmers often make assumption like this. The type of variables won't change during whole function. And the parameter's type can decide the right version of the function. However, consider too the complex of source code and the plenty of variable types in Chakra. These two assumptions may not always correct. We need to know some background of array. Firstly, there are many types of array in Chakra, like showed in this slide. The stored size of JavaScript native int array items is 4 bytes, and the size of float array and var array items is 8 bytes. We push an item into an array whose type is different, the array's type will change. For example, if we push a float item into int array, then the int array will change to float array. Push a var item into float array, then this float array will be changed to JavaScript array. Let's look at the first assumption. In the middle of a function, variable's type could be changed and may lead to confusion. Here is an example. In function for each item in range, the correct version of template for each item in range is chosen, while inside the function, try templated get item can change, can cause user callback. And we can change arrays type in the callback, which can lead to type confusion. Here is a bug to break assumption 2. The bug is in function filter helper. The version of function direct set item at, which is chosen by variable element, is var. But new arrays creation can be interrupted by user-defined callback, and its type may not be var. Then the set operation can cause type confusion. So choose the template function only based on parameter's type is not enough. Mandatory choose the version of a function template will also cause some problems. Developers often do that with the assumption that the type of variable is definitely certain. In Chakra, everything is possible. Using some features in Chakra, this assumption can also be break. For example, in function for each own missing array indexed of object, the variable array can be any type of array, but developer assumes that it must be a var array and explicitly chose the type of template function getItem, which causes a type confusion. Just now, I talked about the issues caused by the function template. Now, let's talk about the problems caused by optimization. Chakra introduced many codes as fast paths for speed. Here are some examples. These fast paths also introduce some potential security problems. here is an exploitable vulnerability inside the fastpass. The root cause is that user-defined callback can be invoked in the middle of the loop. It's here. Inside the callback, we can enlarge array's length, which will lead to overrun of the loop. As Dest argues, it's a local variable, and inside the loop, items of Dest arrays is set. Overwriting of Dest arguments lead to stack overflow. Looking at the top lines of the slide, we can see that because some conditions are met, the code flow goes to the fast pass, and then the vulnerability code is executed. After talking about the optimization, let's look at another attack surface, ES6 features. Up to now, Chakra has the highest level of support for ES6 features, but some new features may destroy the original security model, leading to security problems, for example, proxy. The appearance of proxy in ES6 makes the logic more complex. Proxy can monitor many types of events. In other words, it can interrupt some operation and doing our own work in the middle of that process, then return some data which is controlled by ourselves. There are many kinds of bugs caused by proxies, like unexpected interrupt, unexpected return value, and unexpected logic. Looking at the handles showed in the slide, proxy can monitor a lot of behaviors. We can interrupt some processes and doing our own work in the middle of the process. This can lead to some bugs. Here is an example. This vulnerability exists in the function reverse help. We can see the function use length as an argument, and it's used to set the property of array's segment. And another important finding is that length is used without check. An idea may come into your mind. Can I change the value of length before it is used? We look back from this line and find the function fail from prototype. Inside this function, proxy can be used to invoke user-defined callback, in which we can change array's length and segment's length. So now we can cause the inconsistency of length, which leads to array segments left being set with wrong value. This will finally lead to an overbound write vulnerability. This is a JavaScript that triggers the vulnerability. We use proxy to monitor the get prototype of operation and interrupt the reverse process. The vulnerability is a plan for PongFest 2016 in Korea. But one day before we went to Korea, Microsoft patch comes. The vulnerability is firstly patched in November 2016. After patch, the code became this. Their patch is quite rough. Length is checked before being used. If it is abnormal, array segments left will be set to zero. But is the change good enough, and is the handling proper? The answer is no. The inconsistency is still there. So we changed the PoC and got a new vulnerability. Firstly, we use reverse function to add a segment to element 2. Then we trigger callback in the second reverse using define getter. In the callback, we use onShift to corrupt the first segment. Finally, we can use it to overbound write. So thanks to Microsoft guys, we take this vulnerability as a plan for Pantone 2017, but patches comes again. The patch is in March 2017, still one day before Pantone. This time they update the value of the length before using it. They also made some notes very kindly. So what else can I say? Good job, Microsoft guys. Oh, sorry, I think I showed the wrong emoticon. Now let's talk about another type of vulnerability caused by proxy, unexpected returned value. Normally, when an array is assigned to other objects proto, it will be converted to a var array. Because of this, in function fail from prototypes, developer assume that the variable prototype passed to for each own missing array index of an object will be a var array. But we can use proxy to break this assumption. Proxy can monitor get prototype of operation and invoke user-defined callback. In the callback, we can return any type of arrays. This will lead to type confusion. This is the PoC and the CVE number assigned to it. In the callback, we return the int array to cause type confusion. Here we only briefly introduce the root cause of this bug. Later we will talk this bug as an example to talk about some interesting exploit technologies. Proxy, like a hook in C++, takes control of code execution before the original code is executed. This gives us the ability to confuse has and hasn't. For example, an array has only 3 elements, but using proxy we can cheat the browser that the 10th element is also valid. These hooks may cause logic issues in some cases. Here is a bug caused by this. The bug is triggered by following steps. Firstly, use proxy to monitor the operation of has and treat the function has item to return true. In function getItem, because the array doesn't have the corresponding item actually, false will be returned, but the variable value is not initialized. Then the returned value is not checked in the caller function, and the uninitialized variable subItem is used directly. Now let's look at another new feature, symbol dot species. This feature allows us to rewrite the default constructor of an object. We can use the feature in two ways. Interrupt in the middle of a function and return unexpected type of value. The bug showed in the slide is an example of the second usage. In the bug, a JavaScript constructor returns a JavaScript native int array, leading to type confusion. Now, ES7 is already on the road. The new features are ended. New security issues will become. We have introduced some ways to find bugs in Chakra. Now we will talk about exploit skills. Let's review this bug. It uses proxy to monitor the behavior of getPropertyType of and returned an int array, resulting type confusion. This bug is one of the bugs we prepared for PwnFest 2016. Unfortunately, it was patched just one day before that contest. Though it has been fixed, the skills used to exploit it is interesting. And the exploit of this bug experienced several versions. I will introduce some exploit skills based on this bug. Firstly, this let's simplify this bug. It looks like this. We have two array, array A and array B. Fetch an item from array B in the way of var. Then put it into array A. We can set these two arrays to any type. Then we can get two abilities via this bug. Make a fake object and over a bound array. Next, we will talk about how we can get these two abilities. Firstly, how to make fake objects. We can set array A to a JavaScript array and set array B to an array that we can fully control, like JavaScript native int array and JavaScript native float array. Then the bug will fetch an item from array B and store it in array A as var type. Finally, we can get a fake object in array A, and the object's address is decided by us. Secondly, how to out-of-bound read. We can set array A to JavaScript array, and set array B to JavaScript native int array. JavaScript int array is the element inside is 4 bytes. The size of elements in JavaScript array is 8 bytes. So read items from array B will lead to out-of-bound read. As shown in the slide, the item in green field will be visited and the value inside will be read and put into array A. Now we have these two abilities, how to exploit it. At first, I have no idea about how to use the ability of out-of-bound read, and I just have some information leak bugs in hand. So my plan is combining another info leak bug to make a fake uint 32 array and use it to achieve arbitrary read and write. The bug in the slide can leak the address of any object. Of course, it also has been patched. To make a fake object, two important conditions must be met. Firstly, a fully controllable buffer address. We can modify values of this buffer dynamically and we know its address. Secondly, we need to know the virtual table of that class or the base address of Chakra. For condition one, we can choose the int array with its segment located next to its hand. Its item can be fully controlled, like this. For condition two, we can make a fake uint 64 number element and use presseInt to invoke the function toString. In this function, the item with an address of a value plus 8 will be returned. So using some heap layout, we can read out the virtual table of the next object. Then we get Chakra's base address. Finally, we can make a self-defined uint 32 array and use the leaked array to modify its back and buffer field of the fake array. And then we can achieve arbitrary address read and write. The former exploit used another information leak bug. Can we exploit the vulnerability without help of additional bugs? The answer is yes. Firstly, the field called AUX slots needed to be introduced. The array object in JavaScript is inherited from dynamic object, which has a field called AUX slots. In most cases, AUX slots is null. Symbol can be used to active this field, as shown in the slide. After activated, AUX slots point to a fully controllable var array. Based on this data structure, we have the following plan. Lay out array B and another JavaScript int array end to end and active their AUX slots fields with the ability of out of bounds read out the AUX slots of the array behind array B and put it into array A. Then the stored item in array A becomes an object. The object date is AUX slots is here, and they are completely controllable. Then we fill the fields needed to fake objects, and we can reference the fake object to achieve arbitrary address read and write. So, without information leak bug, if we want to make a fake object, we need to face the problem of pointer. For virtual tables, we can guess the value of the virtual table by enumeration with the help of function is direct access array. Is direct access array is referenced in function concat arguments. In this function, whether the date that a value pointed to is a specific variable is checked, and true or false is returned. After returned, the code flow will go into different branches according to its returned result. Then we can indirectly detect the return state of its direct access array. In short, we can know whether the address we guessed is actually the virtual table or native int array. Here is the code, and the guess function will invoke the concat arguments and will get true or false. Then, after a few minutes, the enumeration will tell us the variable of native int array. The next step is to forge the pointer field type. The structure of type is shown in the slides. Type ID is the most important field, which specifies the type of an object. Other fields is not needed when we forge an item, an object, because we already know the chakra's address. And if we want to forge a native int array, the only thing we need to do is to find a place in the chakra module with the value of 29 inside. So we get the type array address, the typed address, like this. Now we have all the necessary fields of making an array. Finally, we can forge a custom array and set the segment of the array to a uint32 array. Then we can use the custom array to modify backend buffer field of the uint32 array and achieve arbitrary address read and write. We have succeeded in achieving RCE using a single bug, but we have to wait for a few minutes to guess the variable of array. How to solve this problem? We will use another interesting way to solve it. Let me introduce some background we needed to know. In Edge, almost all objects are managed by memory GC. Memory GC killed a lot of UEFI vulnerabilities, but in some cases, UEFI is still occur. Here is one case. Object A is maintained by memory GC, and address A pointed to the start of the object. Address B pointed to someplace inside the object. Object 2 is another object that is maintained by memory GC. It has a field stored address A. If we free object 1 in the JS layer and trigger collect garbage, we will find that object 1 is not really released because of memory GC. However, if we change the value of the field stored address A to address B and try to free object 1 again, we will find that object 1 is freed at this time. Then dangling pointer appeared in object 2. After some kinds of heap function, we can use the object 2 to access the freed content of object 1, leading to UAF. Based on the weakness of memory GC, we can convert the bug to UAF bug. So how to do it? To convert our bug to UAF, we need to do two things. Firstly, to find an internal pointer of an object. Secondly, cache the pointer, and it can be referenced in JS layer. For condition 1, we can choose the segment of arrays whose segment is located next to its head, like this. For condition 2, we can use the ability of outbound read to fetch the pointer and put it into our controllable array. Now we have created a UAF, but use what data structure to occupy the freed array? It's obviously that native int array doesn't fit, although the data is completely controllable, because we do not have information leak yet, so we don't know how to set the data value. Finally, I choose the JavaScript array, because JavaScript array can store objects. As for virtual tables and pointers, they all could be treated as objects and stored in JavaScript array. This is very convenient to make a fake object. The freed and reoccupied process is also shown in the slide. We can see a JavaScript int array is freed, and then we use a JavaScript array to occupy. With the scales talked before, now we put them together to complete the exploit. Specific steps are as follows. Firstly, using out-of-bound read out the three fields of the next array and cache them. Actually, we do not know the value of these fields. They are cached as objects. Secondly, make a UAF and use var array to occupy the freed object. Thirdly, make fake object in this var array. Fill the fields needed. You can notice that the segment field is also set to a uint 32 array. The last step, use the cached dangling pointer JavaScript native int array segment to reference the fake object. And then we achieve an arbitrary address read and write. In previous chapters, we have talked about how to find bugs and how to achieve RCE, but that is not enough to pop up a notepad in Edge. Now we will talk about how to bypass the last barrier, CFG, and maybe RFG. Firstly is bypass CFG. Here is a method methods working version. For CFG, the code without CFG is always an attack surface. With 2 years' efforts of Microsoft, this surface has become smaller and smaller. But if you search the code of Edge, you will find some functions which contain jump instructions that are not protected by CFG all the time. They have similar names and doing similar jobs. There are functions named tail-merge, tail. And they are used to handling the calling of APIs, which is inside the delay-loaded DALs. Another important feature is that they are CFG valid, which means these functions can bypass CFG check. Let's look at one of them. We can see that the jump instruction in the last line is not protected by CFG. Now the problem becomes, can we control the value of RX? Let's look at the function delay load help 2, where RX value comes from. Delay load help 2 finally calls this function. And the value of RX is passed as a fifth argument. Inside the function, A5 address is returned directly if A5 address is not in the image address range of the DALL called the function. So if we can control the RAX value when calling tail merge DALL and sets the address RAX pointer 2 outside of the range of the DALL which called the function, we can jump to there without CFG. Then, how to control RAX when calling tail merge DALL? As tail merge DALL functions can bypass the check of CFG, we can use another function with CFG as a jumper to jump to them. In the meantime, we can also use it to control RAX value. For example, I used this function. The red line shows where the value of RAX comes from. And the blue lines shows where the value of RDR comes from. We can see that their values all come from the object RCX pointer 2. By controlling the object which RCX pointer 2 when calling the function, tail merge DALL will be called in and the RAX value will also be controlled. So, how to control the object which RCX pointer to? I choose the object script function and make RCX pointer to it when invoke jumper function. The structure related is shown in the slide. After leak the address of the JavaScript function object, I fake vitable of script a function object and writes the field git arrays. And writes the git address with the address of jumper function. Then jumper function is called, and when it is called, RCX is just pointed to the JavaScript function object. Here is the whole code flow graph. We can see that when the jumper function is called, RAX pointed to JavaScript function object. And as we have write this object here, so the code flow will come to here. After return to tail merge there, RAX value is 4444, and the jump instruction will be executed, and the code near this address will be executed. Here is the final result. Here is Microsoft patches for this method. In the Windows 10 anniversary update for 64-bit process, the CFG check function now uses dispatch mode by default. So we can hardly control the value of RAX. This feature eliminated available jumper functions. And in Windows 10 Creators update, the functions like tail merge del is set CFG invalid. So they cannot bypass CFG check now. Now let's talk about RFG. RFG is a feature introduced in a former version of Windows 10 to mitigate arbitrary native code execution. But it is disabled in later Windows 10 versions. Here is the design concepts showed by David Weston and Matt Miller in CANSEC West 2017. For more details, you can download their slides via this link. Now we mainly talk about the method to bypass it. The purpose of RFG is to protect the return address of a function. And the implement now is focused on RET instruction. So it now protects the stack in function level. That means RFG only ensures the stack is safe inside the function. The protect scope is like this. But if the stack is already corrupted before entering function test, what will happen? After entering function test, RFG will cache the corrupted value to shadow stack, and before leaving the function, RFG compiles and checks the corrupted value, finding it is not changed. So RFG thinks it is safe and executed it. So we can use this way to bypass RFG. Here is the general bypass pattern. We corrupt the stack, which is used in function B, before entering it. We can see that in both function A and function B, stack is not changed, and RFG thinks it is safe. Actually, stack has been corrupted on a higher level. According to the general bypass pattern, there are many patterns could be used to bypass RFG. This slide shows a typical one. Function A, B, and C are all protected by RFG. Function C is a virtual call. We can rewrite it to another function, function D. Before entering function B, we can corrupt the stack it used. For example, we can corrupt it in function D. And then inside the function B, it used an invalidate state without realize it. When function B returns, arbitrary code execution is achieved. As for function A, I did a simple search and find a lot of functions match this pattern. It could be more in other modules. As for function D, the only requirement is that it can go back to JavaScript layer. That is to say, a user-defined callback should be called. We need to corrupt the stack there. There are also many functions matched, like this one. Function B can be set to any function which protected by RFG. Okay, now is the daemon time. The daemon used the exploit skills we talked before and pop up a notepad in Edge. We can check the Edge version first. It's a formal version. And the exploit is executed. So the notepad comes up. As we used kernel vulnerabilities, so the integrity of the notepad is system. Okay, my speech is finished. Thank you. And any questions?
Test. Any questions for Lam Liu? From the audience right here.
Hi. Can we have a look at the source of the HTML file, please? Just a quick view.
you mean the exploit source code?
Just wanted to see if it was a big mess or if it was a short one. I don't know.
I think the exploit should be worked out by yourself.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. You mentioned a few times, and that's true actually, that the code has been open sourced for Edge. Does this really help your work a lot? Or would you have been able to do it if the code was not
yes,
open?
Yes, I think so. As we can see, the source code of Chakra Core is much more easier to check its security and also work out the exploit.
Any more questions? Okay, thank you. Warm applause for Lam Liu, guys.
Thank you.